In a recent interview, Dr. Greger gave an impassioned plea to the plant milk industry, in which he raises an important concern about the ingredients that is, quote, leading to real problems. Now, it's been a rough couple of weeks for plant milks in the headlines, two of which went viral, and they're actually completely different concerns from the one Dr. Greger has, which we'll hear later in the video. So let's just take a quick look at those before we hear from him. The first was a new study that was said to have found that drinking plant-based milk raises the risk of depression. And the second was a study that stated that not only were plant-based milks found to contain the carcinogen acrylamide, they're also less nutritious than cow's milk and so not a good option. It's my opinion, these headlines were hugely exaggerated, especially when you actually look at the studies in detail. The first was an observational study, which was looking at the occurrence of depression and anxiety in those that drank either semi-skimmed cow's milk, skimmed milk, whole milk, or, quote, other types of milk. And they found that those who drank the other types of milk had a 14% increased risk of depression compared to those who didn't drink milk. But the huge flaw in the study was that the other type of milk category mentioned only one plant milk, which was soy milk, and was unclear on what else was included in that category. The study didn't specify exactly what these other types of milk were that the participants drank, and critics of the study pointed out that the headlines focus on the findings of this other category on the assumption that it is entirely made up of plant-based milk drinkers, but this assumption was not made in the paper itself. All we know is that the other group is made up of soy milk drinkers alongside everyone who selected other, which may include different kinds of animal milk, such as lactose-free or sheep milk. So should we completely dismiss these findings? No, of course not, but way more research is needed. And the second study raised the concern that heat treatment of the ingredients in oat and almond milks in particular generates acrylamide, a carcinogen that's also found in bread, cookies, coffee beans, and fried potatoes. Quote, we were surprised to find acrylamide because it isn't typically found in liquid food. One likely source is the roasted almonds used in one of the products. However, even they said the compound was measured at levels so low that it poses no danger. But they were concerned that if you consume small amounts of this substance from various sources, it could add up to a level that does pose a health risk, which is a fair assessment, but again, I just don't think it warrants such scary headlines. Those reporting on the study also said plant-based milks have significantly less protein than cow's milk, stating the protein which is present in low content is then additionally modified when heat treated, which leads to the loss of some essential amino acids, and that most of these milks have, quote, relatively low nutritional quality. Now, this may be true, but for those of us on a plant-based diet, we really should be getting our protein and other nutrients from foods like beans, lentils, greens, berries, nuts and seeds, etc. But now let's hear from Dr. Greger and what he's most worried about when it comes to plant milks.
This is off topic, I apologize, but anytime I speak to anybody in the all protein industry, please fortify plant-based milks with iodine. Fortify plant-based milks with iodine. I can't say it enough. It is the number one source of iodine in the United States. We don't want people to be eating iodized salt. Why? It's because they feed iodine supplements to cattle. They use iodine-containing disinfectants to disinfect the teats. They add it to the dairy supply. They don't add it to the plant-based milks for some crazy reason, and it's leading to real problems. We don't want vegan goiters in the literature if we can help it. Sorry, high horse.
Not too long ago, a study was released that revealed the number one healthiest plant milk. So we'll discuss that next.